Kittur Chennamma, Indian freedom fighter. Kittur Chennamma was born on the 23rd of October 1778 in Kakati, a small village in the present Belagavi district of Karnataka, India. She received training in horse riding, sword fighting and archery from a young age. She married Raja Mallasarja of the Desai family at the age of 15. Chennamma's husband died in 1824, leaving her with a son and a state full of volatility. This was followed by her son's death in 1824. Rani Chennamma was left with the state of Kittur and an uphill task to save it from the British. Following the death of her husband and son, Rani Chennamma adopted Shivalingappa in the year 1824 and made him the heir to the throne. This irked the East India Company, who ordered Shivalingappa's expulsion, on the pretext of the doctrine of lapse. Rani Chennamma sent a letter to Mount Stuart Elphinstone, Lieutenant Governor of the Bombay Presidency, pleading her cause, but the request was turned down, and war broke out. In the first round of war, during October 1824, British forces lost heavily and St. John Thackeray, collector and political agent, was killed in the war. Amacha Balappa, a lieutenant of Chennamma, was mainly responsible for his killing and losses to British forces. Two British officers, Sir Walter Elliot and Mr. Stevenson, were also taken as hostages. Rani Chennamma released them with an understanding with Chaplain that the war would be terminated, but Chaplain continued the war with more forces. During the second assault, sub-collector of Solapur, Mr. Munro, nephew of Thomas Munro, was killed. Rani Chennamma fought fiercely with the aid of her lieutenant, Sangoli Rayanna, but was ultimately captured and imprisoned at Bahongal Fort, where she died on the 2nd of February 1829. The one of the first female rulers to rebel against British rule, she has become a folk hero in Karnataka and symbol of the independence movement in India. Chennamma was also helped by her lieutenant Guru Siddappa in the war against British. Sangoli Rayanna continued the guerrilla war to 1829, in vain, until his capture. Chennamma's legacy and first victory are still commemorated in Kittur. During the Kittur Utsava will be held between 22 to 24 October every year. The three-day festivities will include sports, cultural programs, and lectures by resource persons on the kingdom of Rani Chennamma. On the 11th of September 2007, a statue of Rani Chennamma was unveiled at the Indian Parliament complex by Pratibha Patil, the first woman president of India. Rani Chennamma's samadhi or burial place is in Bahongal Taluk but is in neglected state with poor maintenance, and the place is surrounded by a small park maintained by government agencies.